for this role. You had never been in a movie before.
No, I'd done TV series before and adverts and commercials and stuff, but I did 6 auditions. First one was just like a 5-minute interview with the casting director, and apparently there were between 2,000 and 4,000 kids going for it. But I never met anyone else. It was all just by myself when I did it. I started off just doing interviews and chats with them, and then they put me on the screen, and I had to act out little pieces. And then I had to go to LA last year, and I met Steven there.
Steven Spielberg.
Yeah.
And what was your conversation with Steven Spielberg like?
First time I met him. Well, he's got like this massive games room in his office, and I was just sitting there playing on the games when he came in, so I was like just flown away when he walked in, so I didn't actually say much to him at that time. But he took me to this office, and I just had to act out this piece. He just chatted to me about what the film's about, and he took me around his offices, showed me E.T.'s head, showed me different things about China, and that was it, really. That was my first meeting with him.
How long were you in Shanghai, and did you like being in China?
I was there for 3 weeks. Not that much, no, I didn't like it. It was good for the first few days, but after that it was just... It's like going back 100 years, really. It's like they all live in these shacks, and the hotel that we were in, it didn't fit in place with everything, because when you look out of the window, there's this massive hotel that we were staying in, and you look out the window and there's all these shacks and people running around in, you know, all dusty coats and thick feather things, and it was a bit boring after a few weeks. It was interesting, but I wanted to get home.
Tell me if I'm right, your mother was a dancer with the circus.
Yeah.
Your father was a commercial airline pilot.
Yeah.
And your grandfather was a comedian.
Yeah.
So there's a little show business in that family.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Did your mother travel with the circus in England?
No, she didn't. When it went on tour, she left and stayed at home with us.
Let's take a look at a scene from Empire of the Sun. This is in an internment camp where you are, right next to a Japanese airfield.
Yeah.
And the Americans come through and bomb that. You are obsessed by airplanes.
I touched them! I felt their heat! I
could
taste them in my mouth! Oil and cordite!
Jim, come back to the hospital! I need some help at the hospital!
Dr. Arnold, do you remember how we helped to build the runway? If we died like the others, our bones would be in the runway! In a way, it's our runway!
No, it's their runway, Jim!
Try not to think so much.
Try not to think so much!
Was it a very difficult physical strain to do that movie?
No, I didn't find it physically strenuous, but before practically every take, in a lot of it, I have to be really whacked out and breathing deeply. And Stephen had me jumping up and down behind the cameras and running for about 5 minutes before every take, so I mean, I got fit through it, yeah.
So, Christian Bale makes his debut in a very big Steven Spielberg picture. What do you hope to do next?
I don't know. I want to do another film.
Do you?
Definitely, but I don't know what yet, because I can only do one film a year because of English laws.
I see, because yeah. You're 13 years old.
Yeah.
I see.
But I definitely want to do acting now.
Well, I wish you luck. Based on your performance in this picture, I think you can have a very, very good career. Now, this was your first television interview ever. What'd you think?
It was fine. I mean, I expected to be really shaking, but I'm okay.
So you had a good time out here today?
Yeah.
Well, we're glad to see you, and congratulations, Christian Bale. I'm sure that we'll see a lot more of you in the screen in years to come.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. We'll be back after this.